edition of SVG Sports Tech On Demand. I'm Jason Dackman, SVG Chief Editor, and I have the privilege of being joined today by Ariel Garcia. He's President and CEO of Chiron, one of the most iconic brands in all of broadcast graphics. Ariel, thanks for joining us today. Where are you calling us from?
Jason, thank you for having me here, and very, very great to be here. I am in Manhattan Beach, California today at home.
Very lucky man. I'm sure that the weather is treating you well. So I know that it's been just an insanely busy past few months for you guys as you guys have carried on through the pandemic. There's been a rebrand. There's been a recapitalization. There's been all kinds of new products and partnerships. So we're going to talk about that today. But let's just very basically start with what has Chiron been up to over the last year? What are some of the highlights?
Definitely, a lot. I would tell you, I took over as a CEO, I know if I mentioned this before, in basically at IBC 2019. So very, very quickly, we got into the pandemic and I didn't have the chance to spend time with a lot of our clients in person and a lot of our partners, but I did spend a ton of time over video and we got to see each other and to know each other in a very different way. I would tell you a lot of our customers, partners, and overall people in the industry know my kids by name at this point. So very, very interesting. In terms of what we've been up to, well, a lot. I mean, I would tell you one of the main things that I'm very proud of and I'm very humbled is to bring back the Chiron brand. As you mentioned, a very, very iconic brand that we had renamed ourselves in the past to Chiron Hego, but there was a lot that that basically the Chiron brand brings to the table. And our objective was to bring back the brand in order to really show basically that we really care about our customers, our clients, all the legacy that we had, and bringing back all that innovation that the brand basically meant for such a long time. So excited to that. As you mentioned, we went through a recapitalization, very important milestone for the company. We did this recapitalization at the end of last year, so at the end of 2020, a very interesting year from a COVID standpoint, but we're very fortunate to have Apollo Management, one of the largest financial institutions in the world, as our partner. And that gives us a lot of flexibility and a lot of investment in order to continue growing, to invest in our customers, and to invest in our product.
Sure.
Out of that, basically, we grew our R&D team, so our product and engineering team, by more than 70%. So this is a very big investment, especially in these times. And that allows us to basically invest in products, invest in our customers, and bring a lot of new products and new innovations into the market that I'm excited to talk about much more. And yeah, I mean, I will tell you, besides that, we continue growing our team across all the different geographies. Today, we have people in over 20 countries speaking 25 different languages. So we are really a global company, and I'm originally from Argentina. So I need to make sure that we have a very diverse set of people that basically allow us to address our diverse set of clients.
Yeah. I mean, great to see the team continue to grow, as well as you mentioned, you know, new versions of some very well-known products, some new products. But let's talk partnerships first, and let's talk some of the things that you guys have been a part of in the sports world since we are SVG. What are some recent really big highlights when it comes to how Chiron has supported sports productions over the last year or so?
Definitely a lot. I mean, we supported everywhere from the Super Bowl 55 to March Madness. And basically all the graphics that you saw on TV are done with Chiron products. We are gonna be part of the Tokyo Olympics with our long standing partnership with NBC Sports. We are also basically supporting CBS Sports on the new innovation with the smart card for PGA, which is a very, very cool product and interesting product. We continue working with MLB in StatCast and PitchCast, all that augmented reality, which is data-driven, which basically brings a very unique experience to all the different fans. We are right now working at the Euro 2020-21, basically supporting basically a lot of different partners, all the way from data extraction, so from data acquisition to automation, to visualization, which is very interesting. The English Premier League with our partnership with PT Sports and Move, doing a lot around venues with the Dallas Cowboys, with the Saints, with the Brooklyn Nets. And with MLS during the pandemics, we partnered very closely in order to get those virtual fans in the stands, as well as all the virtual advertising across the board. And something that I'm very, very proud, because I'm a soccer fan in some ways, is a partnership we had with Univision and TUDN, so Televisa and Univision, with Liga MX, where we brought a full solution where we are using our artificial intelligence, data-driven workflows in order to create real-time visualizations that hopefully we can send you a video that basically shows basically the game in a very unique way. So it feels like you're playing FIFA or you're playing PSA basically on the screen, but you're actually visualizing data in real time, which is something that I think we are the only ones in the world that can do.
Yeah, I mean, it's such a cool product at SVG. We've talked about the Univision League MX coverage so much since it's debuted. From a visual standpoint, from a storytelling standpoint, I think it really kind of takes soccer coverage, football coverage to the next level. Can you tell us a little bit more about how that partnership came to be and how you've worked with Univision and 2DNA to really get that product to where it needs to be?
Definitely. I mean, one of the things that we've been trying to do was to partner with what we consider the key innovators in the broadcasting space and that are really trying to bring their fans, I mean, the football fans or the soccer fans or any other sport fan, a new way to really engage with the content.
Right.
And basically, we have a ton of technology that we've been working over time. And that technology is all based in what I would call modern technologies and modern architectures around artificial intelligence, around data-driven workflows, around basically synchronizing all the different parts of the value chain in order to generate a unique experience. And basically, by working with Oleg in the TUDN team and with many more, basically with Alexis on the Univision side, we were able to work together in a way where we have our camera systems that allow you to get both video and data from each one of the players and the ball in real time, pass that data through basically our artificial intelligence algorithms and use that in order to actually generate the visualizations in real time. So all that is happening in about 1.2 seconds, so 120 milliseconds. So we are able to use that in order to generate augmented reality graphics basically on TV live, which is something that you before you could only watch in a replay. And now we're analyzing games, we're analyzing positions, space of players, pressure, who's playing in different positions, how they are playing, how much they are running, what is the speed they are going through, how much they're running in general. And all that is creating a way to watch and experience the game that is very, very unique. And we continue innovating with Univision until the end. And there's a lot of new innovations that are going to come for the Gold Cup and for next year.
Yeah, no, you're absolutely right when you say that's something that just a few years ago would not have even been thought of as possible. And yet now we're seeing it as reality. And it really does make a difference when you're watching the action. It, as a casual soccer fan, I can tell you that it really allows me to understand the heart of the game a lot more. So many lots of fun sports stories, sports partnerships going on, but you guys have also been pretty busy when it comes to product launches and R&D. So tell us a little bit about how Chiron products have evolved over the last few years and the latest versions that you guys have launched.
A lot. I mean, just to give you a sense of who I am and where I'm coming from, because I'm not originally from the broadcasting industry in general, but I'm always been very, very passionate about basically the intersection between media, video, sports in particular. I play sports all my life and technology. And being able to bring all that together with my experience that has been working with technology companies, modernizing those companies and applying basically the new technologies around cloud computing, around artificial intelligence, it basically really brings me to the point that I would tell you I am walking over the sky in some ways, over the moon. So we've done a lot, and our objective has been, we know that our customers are facing a very important step right now, that where they're trying to move from legacy workflows to modern workflows. However, they cannot move basically from one day on another. And what we need to make sure is that we partner with them in order to provide the solutions that allow them to do this transition. So we work very hard, not in order to go and create the product that is going to be 10 years from now, but to create the product that they need today, and it's going to be the product that's going to carry them for the next 10, 20, 50 years. So we apply a lot of what I would call a cloud computing technologies, so a lot of the underlying technologies in terms of basically Kubernetes, in terms of modularization, in terms of microservices, in order to reimagine all our products. And with that, in the combination with artificial technology, we were able to reimagine our product. One of the key things in our business space is that the advent of cloud computing and the advent of new technologies are allowing to break the barrier that existed today across the workflows and all the different appliances that basically create that workflow. So what we've done was we brought all our products together in some ways in what we call our brand live platform, which basically evolved from what it was basically a top of the line engine, a graphic engine, to a full live production platform, where today we have not only the CG engine, but we also have branding, we have venue control, we have a clip playing. And right now in the latest version, we launch a full, basically live production switcher that have video mixing and audio mixing and automation in order to provide a full production, all software based. And the most important thing is that this can be run on-prem, on the cloud, on hybrid environments, on virtual environments, and basically support SDI workflows, IP workflows, H.264 and NDI all together, all in combination, which I believe we are the only ones in the market that support this type of variety of solutions, because what we really want to do is to partner with our customers in order to move forward.
Yeah, I think what's exciting is you have these established tools that the industry loves from Chiron that are well known, but you guys now bringing the cloud, AI, the rise of IP, the rise of virtualized environments, and allowing people to use those same tools, but in the new world that we are all living in. So I'm sure there's going to be all kinds of exciting stuff coming down the pike beyond what we just talked about today. But for now, Ariel, thank you so much for taking the time. Really appreciate it. And we can't wait to see what Chiron has on the horizon. Stay safe and hope to talk to you in person soon.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me, Jason. And looking forward to seeing you in person soon. And looking forward to tell the world about all the new innovations that are coming. That I will tell you, there's a lot coming up and a lot that we haven't touched today and we can talk about as well.
Great, Ariel. Can't wait. And thanks again.
Thank you.